Welcome to OlliScholar.com. Today I will be taking up a topic from class 10 science, chapter 2, acids, bases and salts. Firstly, in this part I am going to cover acids. So let's see the topics which I am going to cover today. Topics to be covered are a brief introduction. Okay. Then the about indicators, what are indicators, how they are useful, how they can detect the acid and bases. Then the types of indicators, there are basically indicators are classified as four types. We are going to read that. Acids and its properties, all the properties which shows that a particular substance is an acid. Reactions with acid, we will be dealing with different kinds of reaction of acid with metals, reaction of acids with carbonates, bicarbonates, reaction of acid with bases, etc. And the products which are formed when acid reacts with metal, carbonates, bicarbonates and all. Then the classification of acids. In the classification of acids, we will study different types of classification of acids. On the basis of origin of acid, that is whether it is organic or inorganic acid, or whether strength of acid on the basis of strength, whether it is a weak acid or a strong acid. Okay, and likewise we will classify acids in different categories and we will see it. And in the last we will study about acid rain, how the normal rain that is going to have a rainfall converts into acid rain, what happens, how they react with acids present in the atmosphere, the gases present in the atmosphere, they react with them, the water falling from the rainwater reacts with the gases present in the atmosphere and it gets converted into acids. So let's start. We will study in detail about all these topics. So we all are very familiar with the words acid, base and salt, but we will study in detail what is actually it is. So if you remember, the sour and bitter taste of a food, we get some foods taste as sour and some are bitter. Okay, why are it so? This is due to the presence of acid and bases in them. ओके सम वी विल सी दैट कुछ जो होते हैं कि हमें खट्टे खट्टे लगते हैं, कुछ हमारे जो फूड्स आप कह लीजिए या कुछ आइटम्स जो होते हैं, तो ये सब कुछ क्यों होता है? इट इज़ ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एसिड एंड बेसिस बिटवीन दैम. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नेचर केमिकल सब्सटेंस कैन बी क्लासीफाइड एज अ एसिड, बेस एंड सॉल्ट. क्या नेचर है किसी केमिकल सब्सटेंस का, उस बेसिस पे हम इसको क्या क्लासिफाई करते हैं, एसिड, बेस एंड सॉल्ट. जैसे कि आप एग्जांपल ले लीजिए कि जब आप कहीं पे जॉब करते हैं, कोई तो सबकी नेचर ऑफ ड्यूटीज़ जो होती हैं वो डिफरेंट डिफरेंट होती हैं, और जो नेचर ऑफ ड्यूटीज़ होती हैं उसके हिसाब से उनका क्लासिफिकेशन होता है, उनके ग्रेड्स का या कुछ ऐसे. ठीक है, या आपके स्कूल में ही आप देख लो, ग्रेडिंग होती है. ठीक है, ए बी सी डी ग्रेड्स हैं, तो ये कैसे क्लासिफाई होता है, जिस हिसाब से जिसके मार्क्स होते हैं उस हिसाब से क्लासिफाई किया जाता है. ऐसे ही क्या है कि किसी भी केमिकल सब्सटेंस का क्या नेचर है उस हिसाब से हम उसको किस कैटेगरीज में रखते हैं, या तो एसिड में रखेंगे या बेस में रखेंगे, या दे आर कैटेगराइज्ड एज सॉल्ट. ओके, सो इफ वी नो दैट, so if we talk about acids, they are sour in taste, means they are sour को आप क्या कह सकते हैं, जैसे कि acidic taste है, खट्टा है. like आप बहुत common है, हमारे घरों में use होता है, lemon we use, that is acidic. and if we talk about vinegar, that is also acidic. okay, so all of you must be familiar with lemon and vinegar. and the change in the color of litmus paper, if we talk, So in case of acids, it's turned from blue litmus to red. What does acid do? If you take a litmus paper, it turns blue litmus paper in which in red color. Okay? And if we talk about bases, bases are bitter in taste. Okay? So these bases are not sweet in taste, they are bitter in taste and the smell is also not very pleasing. Okay, so the change of color of red litmus to blue, in case of bases, what happens? The red litmus turns to blue. Okay, so if we talk about these litmus paper, why this litmus paper in case of acid turns blue to red and in case of bases it turns red to blue. So it is basically an indicator. If we talk about litmus, it is basically an indicator which is indicating that whether it is an acid or a base. So if we see, in litmus is a very common, okay, very natural, it is a natural indicator we can say, and very common, known to all of us. But there are so many others indicator also which tells us about the substance, whether it is a acid or a base. So before going in detail study of acid, base and salt and having all the chemical reactions and all, I will be delivering a short lecture on the indicators. Okay, which type of indicators are present and what are their functioning, what do they do, and how we come to know that particular is a acid or a base. So first let's study about the indicators, then we will go in detail for about acid, base and salts. Okay, so if we talk about indicators, what are they? They are the substances which indicate acid or basic nature of a solution. Suppose this is a solution, okay? कोई भी solution है, उसका क्या nature है? What is the nature of that particular solution? Whether it is a acid or a base, okay? So the nature of a substance can be known using the seeing the change in the color or the change in the smell. Okay, so basically these are the indicators. What they do, their basic function is to show that whether there is a change in a color of a substance or there is a change in its smell, so that we can get to know that whether it is a acid or a base. So there are many examples we can see in our daily life, that litmus solution, methyl orange, phenolphthalein, methyl red and etc. Like this, there are many indicators. So basically indicators can be divided into four categories. Okay, if we divide indicator, they can be divided in four categories. The first one is the natural indicators, synthetic indicators, olfactory indicators and universal indicators. So these are the four categories. If we divide an indicator, they come under these four categories. So let's study about the natural indicators. What are they? So natural indicators, indicators obtained from natural sources or the one present in the nature. Natural indicators are those indicators, either they are extracted from the natural sources, any of the natural source, suppose they are extracted from it, or it can be the one which is present in the nature by itself. मतलब नेचर में खुद से ही प्रेजेंट है वो ऐसा इंडिकेटर है और आप उसको यूज कर सकते हो जस्ट टू टेस्ट दैट वेदर इट इज अ पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंस इज एसिड और अ बेस. Okay, so they are called as natural indicators. If we talk about the examples, we will see that litmus, turmeric, China rose, different kinds of leaf extract, many leaves extract are there which works as a natural indicators. Okay, Then colored petals of petunia, it is also been indicated as a natural indicator. Okay, these are the common natural indicators which are widely used, okay, to show the acidic or basic characters of a substance. So these are some of the examples of natural indicators which are widely used just to show that whether a particular substance is a acidic in nature or it's a basic in nature. So the first one is the litmus. If we talk about the litmus, it is a purple dye obtained from lichens. Okay, so it is obtained from lichens and the solution of litmus is purple in color. Litmus paper gives two color. Litmus paper do color deta hai. Kaun kaun se? Blue or red. Okay, so what happens? An acid turns blue litmus paper to red. If blue litmus paper turns to red, then particular substance is a acid. Okay, if blue litmus paper turns to the red, then particular substance is a acid. Whereas if it is a base, the red litmus paper turns to blue. Okay, if a litmus paper turns red to blue, it is a base. Okay, so litmus is a very common example of natural indicator and it is very commonly available and you can say it is one of the very basic tests to test any acid or a base. So in the lab, we first of all we test our litmus test is always done since it is a very basic test and it is very easily available. So you can take a small amount of solution in a beaker and just dip a litmus paper in it. You will see the change of color. If the particular solution in a beaker is an acid, it is going to turn in red, blue litmus paper to red. And if a particular solution in a beaker is a base, it is going to turn red litmus paper into blue. Okay. So another natural indicator is a turmeric. Turmeric, which is a normal haldi we use at our home. Turmeric is yellow in color. We all know that it is yellow in color. Turmeric solution of paper turns reddish brown with the base. Okay, what happens if you turmeric, either you take a turmeric solution or a turmeric paper, it gives a color of reddish brown when base has been applied to it. Okay, and in case of acid, it does not show any change in color. So this is a very common example you must have seen. If any turmeric curry or something has been a vegetable curry has been stained on your shirt, what happens? That is yellow in color when it is stained, and when you go and wash it with a detergent, it turns in which color? It turns in reddish brown color. Why is so? Because detergent act as a base, so it gives a reddish brown color to turmeric. Okay, so it does not change color with acid. So it does not give any change in color with acid, as we know. So if you keep on washing that stain after putting a detergent with water, it is washed and washed, you will see that it has been yellow again. The color has been yellow again. Okay, so I think the concept of turmeric has been clear to you. This is a very common and very basic example. You can check this at your home also. If you put somewhere at your shirt or anywhere or turmeric, and when you wash it with a detergent, you will see a change in color and that will be a reddish brown color. This shows that a detergent is a base for turmeric. Okay, and when you wash it again and again with water, it again changes into yellow color. So next we will see next type of indicator is a olfactory indicator. Let's see what is it is. So substances that show odor change okay, order, there is a change in the order, means there is a change in the smell of a substance. Okay, in acidic or basic media. ठीक है, अगर किसी सब्सटेंस को आप एसिड मीडिया में या बेस मीडिया में रखते हैं और उस सब्सटेंस के ऑर्डर में चेंज आता है, ऑर्डर में चेंज मतलब कि उसके स्मेल में चेंज आती है, तो दे आर कॉल्ड एज ऑल्फैक्टरी इंडिकेटर्स. ओके, सो दे आर ऑल्फैक्टरी इंडिकेटर्स. सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द एग्जांपल्स, देयर इज अनियन and vanilla are two very good examples of it. Clove is also a good, clove oil, if we talk, clove oil is also a good example of it. So if we talk about onion, paste or juice of onion loses its smell when added with base. Okay, what happens if you cut a onion or a paste of onion or a juice of onion, or you just cut a onion and keep it with a base. Okay, and add a, you take a onion and you add a base with it. What you will see that the smell of onion has been lost. Normally, onion has a smell and that has been lost. It does not change its smell with acid. But if you put a onion with a acid, it is not going to change its smell. But if you put onion with a base, the smell is lost. And if you talk about vanilla essence, the smell of vanilla vanishes with base. Similarly, as we have seen in case of onion, vanilla smell also vanishes. It means it loses its smell, or its smell has been gone if it is added with a base. But its smell does not vanish with an acid. But if you put it in an acid solution, its smell is not going to vanish. Okay, so this was all the example of olfactory indicators. So there are some indicators that are called as synthetic indicators. Synthetic indicators, if we talk about them, they are the indicators that are synthesized basically. Okay, they are synthesized in labs. Okay, they are not naturally available, or they are not available anywhere, but we have to make it, or we have to synthesize it in labs. Okay, so indicators that are synthesized in laboratory are known as synthetic indicators. So बहुत सारे indicators जिनको कि हम lab में synthesize करते हैं, उनको हम क्या बोलेंगे? Synthetic indicators. Example, if you see, it is phenolphthalein, methyl orange, etc. These are the examples of synthetic indicators. So let's talk about methyl orange. What happens in case of methyl orange? It is used to show acidic and basic behavior of a substance. Okay, methyl orange shows the acidic and basic behavior of a substance. So it is originally yellow in color. जो इसका अपना खुद का color होता है, that is which color? Orange in color. So it turns red with acid and turns yellow with base. Okay, तो क्या होता है methyl orange का? It is orange in color and when it is added in any substance, that is acid, it is going to be red. In case of acid, orange is going to be red. And this orange, when it is added with any substance that is a base, it is going to be yellow. Okay, if it is added in a base. Okay, so another example of synthetic indicator is phenolphthalein. It is also an indicator. It is a colorless liquid. The color of phenolphthalein is colorless, means it has no color. So phenolphthalein remains colorless with acid. If phenolphthalein is added in a acid, it remains colorless only, but it turns pink with the base. So if we talk about phenolphthalein, so when it is added in a acid, it remains colorless only. Means its actual color is colorless only, it has no color, so it remains in that color only. But if that phenolphthalein is added with a base, okay, phenolphthalein is added with a base, then it changes the color of a substance in pink. It is going to change the substance in pink color. Okay, so this was all about, we have gone through three types of indicators: natural, which are found naturally yeah, which occur in the nature. Second one was olfactory, and the third is the synthetic indicators, which is synthesized in labs. There are other universal indicators also, although it is not in our syllabus, so we will not mention it. So basically what happens, these universal indicators are such that ki if we use these type of indicators like the natural indicators, olfactory, synthetic, they only tell us whether the substance is a acid in nature or whether it is a base in nature. Okay, but what happens if we talk about the universal indicators, what they do, they give us a pH value. We get the pH value, that how is strong is that acid or base. Okay, so we can say that these universal indicators give us idea of both the things, whether the substance is acid or base, as well as it also gives us the idea of the strength of a substance. Okay, so universal indicators range different color over a range of pH value from 1 to 14 for a given solution. So it is available in the form of strips and solution both. Okay, so universal indicator is a combination of many indicators such as water, propanol, phenolphthalein, sodium salt, etc. Like this, there are so many salts available, which are you can say that universal indicators are just a combination of all these indicators. So it will give us the strength as well as the acid basic character of a solution. Okay, so let's study about acids now. What are acids, how they function? So acid is defined as one of which produces hydrogen ion in water. Okay, so acid, we can say that they produce hydrogen ion. That is, hydrogen ion, if we talk about, it means H plus ion. Okay, so they produce H plus ion in water. Water means H2O. Okay, so if any of the compound produces H plus ion in water, that is H2O, we called it as acids. There were many theories given about acid by different scientists. Okay, so this theory of H plus ion in water was given by Arrhenius. Okay, Arrhenius, and this theory was called as Arrhenius theory of acid and base. Okay, so Arrhenius gave a theory in which he told that water is, when water is dissolved, it gives H plus ion. Okay, when acid is dissolved in water, it gives H plus ion. Okay, and the other feature of acid is that it gives a sour taste. Okay, that means it is a bit, you can say in Hindi, khatta, sour taste. Okay, then acid turns blue litmus to red. Acid turns blue litmus to red. Suppose in a beaker you take a compound that is acidic in nature and you just drop a litmus paper, you will see that the color of the litmus paper is start changing from blue to red. Okay, and previously we have read about all the indicators So this is one of the very basic tests of acid, that it changes the litmus from blue to red. This is used as confirmation test for the presence of acid. So this is a confirmation test also, as well as you can say that this one is a very basic test, which and very simple test to test that if particular substance is acid or not. So you can take a litmus paper and take it in a beaker and just drop a litmus paper. You will see that it is turning blue litmus to red. Okay, so when acid react with metals, gases are evolved. Okay, so when acid is going to react with metal, gases are evolved. Further, we will see the reactions of acid with different metals and bicarbonates and all in detail we will study. So there are some other features also, that an acid acts as an electrolyte in a solution, or you can also say that an acid neutralizes solution that carries hydroxide ions. Okay, or it reacts with we have already studied that it reacts with several metals, you can say, or it can react with hydrogen gas also, bicarbonate. So many reactions are there. Yeah, carbonate also it reacts. Okay, so many. Now, one very important thing about acid is to remember is that acid destroys our body tissue. So whenever you handle an acid or whenever you do any experiment in your labs, children, be careful that you do not handle it, don't always handle it carefully, because acid is very dangerous to body tissue. You must have been aware of so many acid attacks or acid accidents. So you know that the acid destroys your full face, or if it falls on your hand, it is going to destroy your hand. So it should be handled with very carefully. You should handle it because it destroys the body tissue. Or sometimes what happens, agar acid bahut zyada aap pe gir gaya hai to wo bilkul aapki body ko chhed kar deta hai, matlab skin to kharab karta hai, andar tak wo pura chhed karke chala jata hai. So it's very dangerous. I request you all to please handle it very carefully. Okay, so next, now we will see the reactions of acid, how acid reacts with different kind of metals or other elements. Okay, so the first one is the reaction of acid with metal. Any acid we take and any kind of metal if we take, okay, so what does it give when acid and metal reacts? It gives salt and hydrogen gas. So whenever acid reacts with any kind of active metal, it gives what? It gives a hydrogen gas. Okay, so for example, we can take that it is magnesium here, Mg, and it is reacting with a metal H2SO4. So it gives H2, okay, hydrogen gas H2, and a salt, that is MgSO4, magnesium sulfate. Fine. So whenever an acid reacts with any active metal, it is surely going to give hydrogen gas. Here in this example also, you can see that it is reacting with a metal and it gives a salt, that is MgSO4, magnesium sulfate, and a hydrogen gas H2. Fine. So next is that reaction of acid with carbonates. What happens when acid reacts with carbonates? So acid reacts with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates to give carbon dioxide. Okay, fine. So what happens if suppose any acid is there, it is going to react with any of the metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate also it can react. Okay, hydrogen carbonate, and what the product formed is carbonate, sorry. So the product formed will be having carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. Fine. So here in this example, you can see Na2CO3 is there. It is reacting with an HCl and it gives NaCl, H2O and CO2. That is a carbon oxide gas is released. Okay. When acid is reacting with carbonates, any kind of carbonate, here you can see it is a metal carbonate. Okay, Na2CO3, it is reacting with an acid. Acid is HCl, so it gives a carbon dioxide, a gas carbon dioxide. Okay, acid can react with carbonates as well as they can also react with bicarbonates. Okay, so just now we have seen that it reacts with carbonate, then it gives carbon dioxide as a gas, and when it reacts with bicarbonates like NaHCO3 and here is an acid HCl we have used, again it is producing a carbon dioxide. So we can say that acid reacts with a carbonates or bicarbonates to give carbon dioxide. Okay. And in other word, we can also say that an acid reacts with base. Further, we will study about base. This is a base, NaHCO3, and it reacts with a base to give salt and water. This is a salt, NaCl, and H2O is a water. Okay. And this type of reaction in which acid reacts with a base to give salt and water, this type of reaction is called neutralization reaction. Neutralization reaction. Okay. So here if you will see, this is a salt and this is a acid. Acid is reacting with a base. Okay. And it gives a salt and this is a water. Fine. Okay, and this reaction. So next, when an acid reacts with metals, what happens? If an acid reacts with metal oxide, it gives what? It gives a salt and a water. So it is a metal oxide, acid is reacting, CuO, and this is a acid, H2SO4. What it is giving? It is giving CuSO4 and this is a salt. Okay. And it is giving H2O. What H2O is? A water. So we can say that if an acid reacts with metals, okay, it gives salt and water. Okay. So this was all about reaction of acids with the different compounds like carbonates, bicarbonates, metals. Okay. And next we will see different classification of acids are there on different bases. So we can classify acid as a strong acid and a weak acid on the basis of their strength. Okay. So if we classify acid on the basis of their strength, we can classify acid in two types. One is the strong acids and the other is the weak acid. So what are the strong acids? Strong acid iodized fully in water. What happens if you take a water, suppose, and you put a strong acid in it? It is going to iodize fully. Okay. And what does it produce? What the products are formed? They produce large number of H plus ions, that is hydrogen ions. Okay, so they strong acids iodize fully in water to produce large number of H plus ions. And if we see the examples, here is a good example, hydrochloric acid, that is HCl. When you dissolve it in a water, H plus is released. Okay, large number. Then comes the sulfuric acid, H2SO4. In that also, it iodizes fully in water to produce large number of H plus. Then comes the nitric acid HNO3. Here also H plus ions are there. Similarly, there are so many examples like hydrobromic acid is also there, HBr. Again, a H plus ion will be formed. So these are all the examples of a strong acid. So a strong acid is an acid which iodizes fully in a water to produce large number of H plus ions. So all these examples which I have given you here, they give large number of H plus ions. Next comes the weak acids. So if a strong acid is iodizing fully in water to produce large number of H plus ions, so students, you can guess what a weak acid may be. Obvious hai ki the weak acid is not going to produce a large number of H plus ions. Let's see. So they iodize partially in water. Okay, or you can say that weak acid does not dissociate or does not iodize in water. And if they iodize also, they iodize partially, incomplete. Okay. If you take any aqueous solution, so it is going to dissociate or iodize partially to produce a small number of H plus ion. Okay, so they were iodizing fully in water, they are iodizing partially or incomplete iodization is there, and they give a strong acids gives a large number of H plus ions, whereas weak acid gives a small number of H plus ions. Let's see the examples here. Here is a carbonic acid H2CO3. It is a very good example of a weak acid. And then comes the phosphoric acid H3PO4, sulfurous acid H2SO3, and the acetic acid. Acetic acid is very good example of weak acid CH3COOH. It is a very weak acid. Okay, so if we talk about the differentiation, if you see how acid can be categorized as a strong and weak acid, we will get to know that it can be determined on the basis of H plus ion produced. So if H plus ions are produced in a large number, it will be a strong acid, and if H plus ion is produced small in number, we will say it is a weak acid. Okay, so strong acid is the strength is strong of that acid, and weak acid the strength is low. Okay, so if we see the concentration of an acid, we can classify acid of two types. One is the dilute acid and other is the concentrated acid. Okay, so acid can be dilute acid or it can be a concentrated acid. So one which has low concentration of acids in aqueous solution, they are known as dilute acids. अब क्या है, कोई भी aqueous solution है आपके पास, like water is there or some other aqueous solution. So if the concentration of acid की concentration इसमें क्या है, low है. मीन्स कि अगर एसिड की कंसेंट्रेशन लो है तो इसमें कंसेंट्रेशन हाई किसकी होगी, वाटर की, या जो दूसरा सोल्यूशन है उसकी. ओके, सो इट्स इस टाइप के एसिड को क्या बोलते हैं, डाइल्यूट एसिड. जैसे आप एग्जांपल भी ले लीजिए कि अगर आपको किसी जैसे कोई एसिड है सपोज, और आपको उसको बोला जाए कि आपको उसको डाइल्यूट करना है, तो आप क्या करते हो, आप उसमें बहुत सारे वाटर को डाल दोगे. ठीक है, तो जब आप वाटर उसमें डालना शुरू करोगे तो एसिड की जो कंसेंट्रेशन है वो कम होती जाएगी. ओके, प्योरली अगर कोई एसिड है तो ठीक है, वो बहुत ही कंसेंट्रेटेड है, बट अगर आप उसमें कोई एक्वा सोल्यूशन, कोई वाटर या कुछ मिला रहे हो, तो वो उसकी तो कंसेंट्रेशन कम हो रही है, उसका गाढ़ापन जो है एसिड का वो कम हो रहा है. वेयर इज वन विच इज हाई कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ एसिड्स इन एक्वस सोल्यूशन आर नोन एज कंसेंट्रेटेड एसिड. अब कोई एसिड है जो बिल्कुल प्योर है, पूरा एसिड ही है उसमें, इट इज नॉट हैविंग एनी काइंड ऑफ एक्वस सोल्यूशन और सम अदर थिंग इज मिक्स विद इट, तो वो बहुत थिक होगा, इट विल बी कंसेंट्रेटेड. ओके, So these type of acids are called concentrated acids, and one which is having low concentration, they are going to be called as dilute acids. Okay, so it is advised to add acids. This is a very important note. I'm telling you only this because further in future classes, or if you are doing practicals in your classes, you should please note it. This is a very important thing to be noted. It is advised to add acid to the water, not vice versa. Means आप एक कंटेनर में एसिड लीजिए, ओके, एंड नाउ इन दैट कंटेनर यू कीप एडिंग वाटर, ओके, सो यू हैव टू एड एसिड टू वाटर, सॉरी मतलब दिस प्रैक्टिस यू शुड नॉट डू. You have to add acid to water. Like if you are adding water to acid, it is going to be very dangerous. So you should not perform this kind of practice. This is a wrong practice. Wrong. So what basically you have to do? You have to take a container in which you have to put water in that container. Okay. Water is there in a container. And now what you have to do, you have to add acid in it. You have to add acid in it. अब क्या होता है basically कि अगर आप acid में water को डालोगे तो acid की ऊपर आने की chances हो जाती हैं. Suppose आप water को डाल रहे हो acid में तो acid can come out. ठीक है, क्योंकि वो क्या हो रहा है, वो dilute हो रहा है, तो वो ऐसे ऊपर आ सकता है, तो मे बी कोई मिसहैपनिंग हो सकती है, वो आपके फेस या आपके किसी बॉडी पार्ट्स में आ सकता है. इसलिए यू शुड ऑलवेज पुट टेक अ एसिड इन अ वाटर. ओके, एंड द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट बिकॉज लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इज रिलीज इफ वाटर इज एडेड टू एसिड. अब आप वाटर को ऐड करेंगे एसिड में तो लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड रिलीज होगी और वो बाहर की तरफ आएंगी तो आपके फेस या आपके किसी पार्ट्स को अफेक्ट कर सकते हैं. दिस रिलीज हीट इज लार्ज एनफ टू कॉज हार्म. द सेम थिंग आई हैव टोल्ड यू कि इट कैन कम आउट ऑफ द बीकर और द कंटेनर इन विच यू आर एडिंग वाटर इन विच ऑलरेडी एसिड इज देयर. सो ऑलवेज एड एसिड. सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द ओरिजिन ऑफ अ एसिड, दैट फ्रॉम वेयर इट हैज़ बीन फाउंड और फ्रॉम वेयर इट हैज़ बीन ओरिजिनेटेड, we can classify acids in two types. One is the organic acids and the other is the mineral acids. So this is basically on the basis of their origin, from where the acids have been originated. Okay, so acids are always, मतलब यू कैन से कि दे कैन बी डिराइव, लाइक समटाइम्स दे कैन बी डिराइव फ्रॉम लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, ओके, लाइक प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स. ओके, इफ एसिड इज अ डिराइव फ्रॉम प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स, दीज टाइप ऑफ एसिड्स आर कॉल्ड ऑर्गेनिक एसिड्स बिकॉज दे आर डिराइव फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सिट्रिक एसिड इज प्रेजेंट इन फ्रूट्स. देर आर मैनी फ्रूट्स इन विच सिट्रिक एसिड इज प्रेजेंट. You all eat orange, lemon, all these fruits have a good citric acid. Kiwi is there, it has also a good citric acid is there. Next come the acetic acid. Everybody eats vinegar. Okay, so in vinegar a huge amount of acetic acid is present. Okay, this is a weak acid. If we talk about the strength, it is a weak acid. Next comes the oxalic acid. That is present in tomatoes. Tomatoes contain a huge amount of oxalic acid. And then tartaric acid is also there. That is present in tamarind. That we called as imli. Usme kaun si acid present hoti hai? Tartaric acid. It is because of that it gives a sour taste. Okay. It is because of that it gives a sour taste. So lactic acid is also there, which is present in milk and curd. Okay, if we make a curd from a milk, what generally, matlab what is the process? It is that we are generating a lactic acid. सो ऑल दीज एसिड्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट मतलब ईटेबल्स यू कैन से और डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स दीज ऑल एसिड्स हैव अ सावर टेस्ट एंड दे आर कॉल्ड एज ऑर्गेनिक एसिड्स. Okay, so these are very common examples. Citric acid, fruit, everybody eat. We eat orange, lemon, all these. Okay, vinegar is always used. We use in different forms in chowmein and all. So their acidic acid is present. Tomato in every house we use as a vegetable. In that oxalic acid is present. Intermittent tartaric acid is present. And curd, we all eat curd. You all know that curd is made up of milk. It is made with milk. So in that, lactic acid is present. Okay, so this was all about organic acids. Let's see from where these mineral acids are originated. If we talk about mineral acids, these are also called inorganic acids. So we can also say that on the basis of origin, acids can be of two category. One you can say is organic acid, and the other one is a inorganic. Okay, so if we talk about inorganic acid, they are also called as mineral acids because they are derived from some kind of minerals. So if these type of acids are bit dangerous, okay, minerals acid or inorganic acid, they are dangerous. Okay, they are dangerous in the sense that they are harmful to us. For example, sulfuric acid is there, or hydrochloric acid, HCl ka to sabne hi suna hoga ki if it falls on your body, it destroys your body tissues, it burns your skins. Okay, so this was all about mineral acids. Fine. So what happens to students ki organic acids are always, matlab if you talk about organic acid, you will see that they are always weak acids. As we have read all these examples, acetic acid we have just before we have read in weak acid. But what happens in case of mineral acids, they can be a strong acid or they can be a weak acid, both is possible. Okay. And one more thing is that these organic acid, that is the weak acids, we can take in our body. We eat it. We eat these fruits. We eat these vinegars. We eat tomatoes. We eat tamarind. We eat curd. But we can't take in our body these mineral acids. You can't eat H2SO4. You can't eat HCl. Okay. Next is what that acid can be can be categorized on the basis of number of hydrogen ions present in it. Okay, so it is named after the number of hydrogen ions present in it. Acid can be classified on that basis. So it is a monoprotic acid. Monoprotic acid means the one which gives one mole of hydrogen ions per mole of acid. Mono means one. So monoprotic acid is the one which gives one mole of hydrogen ions per mole of acid, and the example is HCl. HCl gives one mole of hydrogen, that is only H plus. Then comes the diprotic acid. Diprotic acid is the one, as the name suggests, di means two. Okay, so it means ki two hydrogen ions it is going to give. So diprotic acid is the one which produces two mole of hydrogen ions per mole of acid. So for example, H2SO4, it is going to give 2H plus ion. Okay. So di means 2H plus ion it is going to give. So diprotic acid is the one which gives 2 mole of hydrogen ions per mole of acid. So agar isko consider kare aur isi tarike se, we will see that there is a triprotic acid. Triprotic is the one which gives, tri means 3. So 3 mole of hydrogen per mole of acid is called as triprotic. On the, as the name suggests, 3. Okay, three tri means three. So the example of triprotic can be H2PO4. Sorry, H3PO4. Okay, triprotic का example क्या हो जाएगा? H3PO4. So it is going to give 3 mole of H plus ions. So it is called as triprotic. As the name itself suggests, tri means 3. Okay. And similarly, there is polyprotic. Poly means many. Poly says many. As the name suggests, many. So polyprotic means many moles of hydrogen ions per mole of acid is produced. Okay. So this kind of acid is going to be called as polypretic. Means they can produce more than 3 H plus ions per mole of acid. So as the name suggests, it is polyprotic. So next is the acid rain. Okay, what is acid rain? If we talk about acid rain, we know that nowadays there has been lots of pollution. Air pollution, water pollution is there. Nature is so much polluted. So acid rain is basically what we can say that due to air pollution, when the air is getting polluted nowadays, we all know that many harmful gases like nitrogen dioxide, NO2, and sulfur dioxide, that is SO2, come into atmosphere. अब क्या हो रहा है, एयर को इतनी पोल्यूटेड हो गई, इतना पोल्यूशन हो गया कि उसमें बहुत सारी हार्मफुल गैसेस आ गई हैं, जैसे कि नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड है, सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड है, ये सब हमारे एयर पोल्यूशन के वजह से हैं। अब होता क्या है, दीज नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड और दीज सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड फॉर्म नाइट्रिक एसिड। ये क्या बनाते हैं, ये नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड और ये सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड ये क्या बनाते हैं, ये नाइट्रिक एसिड बनाते हैं। ओके, what they make nitric acid and sulfurous acid. So nitrogen dioxide makes nitric acid and sulfur dioxide makes sulfurous acid on reaction with water. Okay, so when NO2 reacts with H2O, that is water, it gives nitric acid, and nitric acid is a acid. And when sulfur dioxide, this is SO2, reacts with water, that is H2O, it gives sulfurous acid. Okay, so when rain drops mix with these gases, अब क्या है, जब बारिश होगी, when there is a rainfall, so जब rain ऊपर से आएगी, तो obvious है कि ये air pollution की वजह से ये जो है, मतलब ये these gases हैं, ये हमारी आपकी नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड या सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड, ये कहीं ना कहीं एटमॉस्फेयर में कहीं ना कहीं प्रेजेंट होंगी ये गैसेस। तो जब बारिश होगी, जब ऊपर से रेन की ड्रॉप्स गिरेंगी, रेन की ड्रॉप्स ऐसे आएंगी ऊपर से, तो क्या होगा कि दे फॉर्म एसिड रेन। अब ये इनसे रिएक्ट कर जाएंगी, बारिश के पानी को हम H2O मान लें, इट इज़ अ वाटर, और ये कहीं ना कहीं इनसे रिएक्ट करेंगी नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड और सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड गैसेस से, और वो फॉर्म करके क्या बनाएंगी, नाइट्रिक एसिड और सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, और इसी को हम क्या कहेंगे, एसिड रेन। इसका मतलब क्या हुआ, वो जो रेन हुई वो तो नॉर्मल जो रेन आ रही है, जो पानी आ रहा है एटमॉस्फेयर से, वो तो नॉर्मल पानी था, H2O था, ठीक है। लेकिन हुआ क्या कि H2O को रास्ते में तो मिल गए, मिला कहीं पे, सॉरी H2O को कहीं पे तो मिल गया NO2 और कहीं पे मिल गया आपका ये SO2। तो अब ये तो इनसे रिएक्ट कर गया और बना दिया नाइट्रिक एसिड और सल्फ्यूरस एसिड। तो अब जो पानी हमारे पास आ रहा है, दैट इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू बी अ नॉर्मल H2O। वो केवल पानी वाला H2O नहीं है, वो जो हमारे पास आया वो ये नाइट्रिक एसिड और सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड आया। ओके, तो इस टाइप की जो रेन हुई, इसको हम एसिड रेन कहेंगे। है तो रेन, बट इस रेन में एसिडिक एसिड्स प्रेजेंट है, दैट इज नाइट्रिक एसिड एंड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, तो दे आर कॉल्ड एज एसिडिक रेन। अब लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द हार्मफुलनेस, या क्या हार्म देता है इन एसिड रेन से, हमें क्या हार्म होता है। सो एसिड रेन तो बॉडी को तो जो हार्म देता है ही है, एसिड रेन इज ऑल्सो कॉजिंग अ डैमेज ऑफ हिस्टोरिकल मोनूमेंट्स. बहुत सारे हमारे ऐसे हिस्टोरिकल मोनूमेंट्स हैं जो इन चीज़ों के बने होते हैं कि जिनकी वजह से जब ये रेन एसिड रेन इन पर पड़ती है तो उनके मटेरियल्स को नुकसान होता है, दे आर गेटिंग डिग्रेडेड. ओके, और बहुत सारे हिस्टोरिकल मोनूमेंट्स हैं या बहुत सारे अदर बिल्डिंग्स भी हैं. अब एग्जाम्पल के लिए हम ले लेते हैं ताजमहल. Everybody is aware of Taj Mahal, कि it is made up of very nice marble. और सबको इसकी कहानी पता होगी कि कहाँ से ये मार्बल आया था और कैसे क्या हुआ था. तो it is basically a very precious marble. तो Taj Mahal, which is made up of marble, is getting damaged. अब क्या हो रहा है, वो ख़राब हो रहा है. It is getting damaged because of reaction with acid rain. अब क्या होता है कि marble है, ये building है marble की, अब इस पे जो रेन गिरी वो एसिड रेन जब गिरी तो दीज मार्बल्स आर गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विद दीज एसिड रेन्स. और इस रिएक्शंस के कारण ये जो मार्बल के टेक्सचर्स हैं या उनकी जो शाइनिंग है उन पे इफेक्ट आ रहा है, वो ख़राब हो रहे हैं. ओके, दे आर गोइंग टू लुक वियर्ड और यू कैन से पुराने हो रहे हैं, या उनके कलर में थोड़ा सा चेंज आ रहा है, या उनमें थोड़ा सा खुदरापन आ रहा है बिकॉज ऑफ दीज एसिड रेन्स. सो मार्बल इज़ अ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट. ये मार्बल्स किसके बने हैं, कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट के. और जब इन पे एसिड रेन्स, दैट इज़ द नाइट्रिक एसिड एंड सल्फ्यूरस एसिड इज गोइंग टू फॉल ऑन इट, इट इज़ गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विद दीज एसिड्स. दिस कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट इज गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विद नाइट्रिक एसिड, दिस कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट विल रिएक्ट विद सल्फ्यूरस एसिड. ओके, और इसको क्या बोल मतलब इसको नुकसान पहुँचा रहा है, एंड दिस गेटिंग कोडेडेड. ओके, सो बेसिकली एसिड रेन को हम कहेंगे कि इट इज़ नॉट यूजफुल टू अस, इट इज़ ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ द पोल्यूशन अकरिंग इन आवर एटमॉस्फियर. सो वी शुड कंट्रोल द पोल्यूशन. अगर हम कंट्रोल करेंगे पोल्यूशन को, ये जो भी एटमॉस्फियर में पोल्यूशन है, तो ही हम एसिड रेन को कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं, और जो नॉर्मल वाटर है रेन का वो हमारे तक आ सकता है. अगर पोल्यूशन ऐसे ही बढ़ता रहा तो ऐसे ही बहुत सारे एसिड्स लाइक नाइट्रिक एसिड, सल्फ्यूरस एसिड, ये बढ़ते जाएंगे हमारे मतलब एटमॉस्फेयर में, क्योंकि गैसेस नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड गैसेस बढ़ती जाएंगी. तो जब वाटर आएगा और इनसे रिएक्ट करेगा तो नाइट्रिक एसिड और सल्फ्यूरस एसिड, ये एसिड्स हमारे ऊपर या डिफरेंट मोनूमेंट्स या बिल्डिंग्स पे गिरेंगे. ओके, so students, this was all for today. Hope you have got a good knowledge of acids, about the reactions they are taking place, and how these acid rain is very harmful to us. If you like my lecture, please do subscribe our channel, and you can also visit our website www.olliescholars.com. thank you so much. Thank you for watching my video.